teams are starting to know what they have.
Yeah, BA, sometimes it takes a while with personnel changes or coaching changes too. But now you have a good chunk of games under your belt and the camaraderie has grown.
So the Houston starting five. Van Vliet and Green, they're manning the backcourt. Smith and Şengün play together in the front court. And it's Brooks in at the three.
Well, Van Vliet likes to work up close and personal at the basket, always ready to take it inside.
Outside, Green fires in the triple.
And that's what they want to do, get him open looks early.
And Van Vliet has got the ball here for the Rockets. Pass to Şengün. And here's Smith. Green covering. Van Vliet against Curry. Now here's Van Vliet. Tight defense on him. Two shots, two makes. Off to a good start.
The defense gets physical inside, and guess what? The tenacious Fred Van Vliet ready for it.
Outside heel. Outside for Green. Jackson Davis, a screen. Six on the shot clock. And it's Green missing. Van Vliet outside. Inside. Here's Smith. Ooh, and he took a hard foul on the shot. So he'll head to the line to shoot a pair. It's going to go on Draymond Green.
And I like to see this from Smith. Pushing the action, not just hanging around the perimeter.
First one falls for him, and the third pick in 2022. Jabari Smith Jr., he struggled at times in his rookie season, but Clark, he's making some major strides now.
You know, B.A., you've heard me and others say this, but every player runs their own race. Everybody's development journey is their own, to own and to run. Sometimes it just takes a little while longer for guys to adjust at this level. But I tell you one thing about that young man, the progress he made lets you know he's got what it takes to one day be an all-star in this league.
Green. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot two. That one on Şengün.
There's always a spot for a guy like Draymond Green on your side. An incredible defender. He's unselfish offensively and a highly skilled passer.
Shooting two.
No good on that one.
Yeah, in terms of winners in NBA history, few have the resume of Draymond Green.
And he's good on the second. The Rockets have gone 2 of 3 from the floor. Van Vliet, the pass to Şengün. On the wing, Brooks. Back to Green. Şengün, a screen on heel. Green for three. He buries it from three.
Green getting very aggressive on the perimeter and really good concentration as he focused on his shot.
Van Vliet against Curry. Jackson Davis, a screen. Puts up a three. It's hauled in by Houston.
Kevin, you can understand the shot selection. I mean, he wanted to go back at him and just came up short on the triple.
On the wing, Green. And Houston, another three.
They've hit four of their first five shots. Great execution and attention to detail.
And Steve Kerr calls timeout here. He'll take the opportunity to regroup. They're coming off a win against the Nuggets.
Sometimes it's difficult to get good looks on the road, but they ran the offense brilliantly.
And it was funny, the road arena didn't bother them at all. I mean, they locked in, focused, and executed, and got it done.
Now let's check out the Western Conference standings and see how they look here in December. Taking a look at the Rockets. Still early, but they have the third best record in the conference. And checking out the Warriors. Behind two games.
When I look at Houston, you have to really give it to them. I mean, they are backing up all the preseason hype. They've been outstanding early.
It appears to me, though, that this group has all the ingredients for a special season.
Now, here's Green. 17 points in his last outing. Smith against Heald. Here's Green. And there's the rejection. In transition, here come the Warriors. Here's Curry. Gets his second attempt to go. Now he's 1 for 2.
Working that in-between area, Steph likes to keep the defense on its heels.
And let's send it over to Ali LaForce.
Head coach Steve Kerr and I got a chance to talk for a bit. We talked about how Alperen Şengün can act as a facilitator. Coach said he sees the floor like nobody else. He's got a great mind for the game. And if you let him find his guy out of the high post, he will punish you. No doubt about it, they're aware. He is the engine of this offense.
All right, Ali, thanks once again. And the Rockets with possession here. After the Warriors picking up a basket just a moment ago. Outside, Green. Brooks a screen on Curry. Van Vliet outside. There's the three. Sinks it from distance. Van Vliet's got 7.
And they've settled in quickly today. A nice flowing rhythm to their offense.
Yeah, they're lasered in. I mean, really making the most of their possessions. Making the impossible look easy. Wiggins with the great creativity in the air. He typically hangs in the air a little longer than the average bird, though.
Once again, an explosive highlight on the AT&T 5G Slam Cam. So it's the Rockets now. They lead by 4. They put up a nice win against Sacramento last time out.
And it wasn't just their starters putting in work. Their backups were real spark plugs on offense.
Absolutely, especially on the road when you need those guys off the bench to up the ante.
Oh, nice! Oh, big finish!
Man.
And he goes in for the dunk.
Finishing with authority, you like to see Wiggins playing with that kind of attitude and edge.
Van Vliet scanning the floor to the paint. Tipped away. Here's Şengün. And the rebound goes to the Warriors.
Probably should have scored there. He usually does.
And it's Green off the drive. That drops, and it comes off an assist from Curry. Green's got his second basket.
They have no answer defensively inside.
Yeah, and that's 4 straight field goals now they've allowed from point-blank range. Can't happen.
Now here's Van Vliet. He had a 12-point outing in their last game against Sacramento.
And more impressive to me than his scoring was his playmaking. Really an all-around offensive clinic.
Pass to Heald. Back to Curry. Tipped.
Lots of athleticism for the long center. Şengün getting it done.
Here's Brooks. Not enough on that one as it misses.
It can be tough to find space in the mid-range area. Probably should have passed that one up.
And the basket by Heald.
Boy, at the offensive end, his game is so impressive. I mean, he's a threat every time up the floor.
Now, here's Green. Against Sacramento, he was really on his game. Van Vliet, the pass to Şengün. Soft touch off the glass.
Trading the lead back and forth, neither side is willing to back down.
Yeah, and the lead has changed hands, and it just hasn't stayed in those hands very long when it's changed.
Timeout.
Back and forth we go.
And Steve Kerr calls timeout here. He wants a few moments to regroup with his players. Thompson. He's checked in for Houston. A group of teams that love to run. The NBA leaders in fast break scoring. The Rockets second.
When it comes to transition play, this team outperforms most others. They've got a lot of speedy players, and they use them well.
Green against Heald. Wiggins outside.
And, you know, that's going to be free throws. I mean, the length and quickness of Wiggins forcing the defender's hand there.
All right, a moment to look at the scoring approach in terms of where the points are coming from here for Houston.
Yeah, their early focus on outside scoring has paid off. They're finding plenty of points from three-point land.
In addition to that, they've thrown their weight around inside tonight, too, thumping and bumping in the paint. A lot of their points have come from inside.
The free throw drops for Wiggins.
A decent free throw shooter is Wiggins, trying to become more than that, though, given how often he gets himself to the line.
And Houston making a change here. Adams is checked in. He does not get the second one.
Couldn't put them in the lead, but at least does enough to tie it up.
Green against Heald. Van Vliet outside. Smith left side. Shot clock at three. Late clock. Houston's got to hurry. The three from Thompson. And the rebound goes to the Warriors. They just couldn't come out on top last time they took on the Rockets. That one was in Houston.
Last time they lost a close one against this team. You have to wonder what they could have done if it wasn't for their foul trouble in that game.
When you are in foul trouble, it makes you less aggressive defensively. And when that's the case, it's hard to offer the kind of resistance that you need to. That was in the back of the mind, the foul trouble they were in.
Curry against Van Vliet. Pass to Wiggins. Back to Curry. Shoots it from the high post. And the basket is good.
Nice assist there. Typically attacking with the scoring move. This time, Wiggins attacks with the pass.
And Grant, once again, Stephen Curry hit 300 threes last season. Man, he's in a class of his own.
Well, there have been 7 300-plus three-point seasons ever. Stephen has 5 of them. He has the only 400 three-point year ever. So, yeah, B.A., Stephen has created his own class. We've seen that more than once today. An effortless basket inside.
Well, listless and lifeless at the defensive end. I mean, especially inside. They've really got to pick up that interior defense.
Wiggins, no good. Houston in the lead. Van Vliet outside. To the inside. That's good from Adams on the assist from Van Vliet. Van Vliet's got 3 assists tonight.
They're finding ways to get the ball into the paint. 5 consecutive buckets.
And on the flip side, the defenders have to show more fight on the interior. They've got to offer more resistance here.
Now here's Curry. What a tremendous game he played against Denver.
0 fear from Curry inside. 2 more points in his Hall of Fame career.
Thompson outside. Back to Van Vliet. And how about the Fred Van Vliet story? From undrafted to all-star and NBA champion.
It's one of the remarkable journeys in the history of the league. There are a number of guys that have gone undrafted and ended up being all-stars and champions. But you think about it, one of the things they have in common in my mind, B.A., is a real understanding of who they are and what it's going to take to be successful. And then the willingness to put in the work and not be distracted by naysayers or the glamour of being a pro. They've got a real anchoring as to who they are and what their business is about, and then they maximize their ability. That's Fred Van Vliet in a nutshell.
Kuminga, he's checked in for the Warriors. Pajimski comes in for Andrew Wiggins. Both free throws, good from Van Vliet.
That's what he does. Rock solid at the line.
Outside heel. Van Vliet against Curry. Oh, Adams with the block.
Oh, a fantastic defender. Adams embraces his role on this team as their defensive anchor. Attacking the rim with power.
Tremendous finish.
Really piling on the lead with a dunk like that.
Now here's Kuminga. His numbers are solid, putting up around 18 points a game. Jackson Davis, a screen. Heald fires from way outside, from beyond the arc, and then some. Heald's got his second basket on the night.
No hesitation, even from deep, deep range. Heald is a solid shooter.
And Ime Udoka has called timeout. He wants to make sure everybody's on the same page. All right, the Rockets making a switch here. Whitmore's checked in. Van Vliet outside. Got it. Makes him 4 for 6 from the floor.
And he's carried them this quarter. A dominant offensive stretch.
Warriors trail by 5. Now Pajimski. No points yet. Jackson Davis, a screen. Up top Pajimski. Defended by Thompson. Just 4 to shoot. From deep 3-point land. The shot by Pajimski, no good.
Well, I don't think there's any question about it. They came focused and ready to play. I mean, they're doing everything they can to put things in their favor. You earn that, and they're actually earning it well right now.
The defense there doing whatever they can to protect the rim.
Definitely saved the layup with that foul, and he'll make him earn them from the line, and that's what you want to see.
And he drops a first. Looney's checked in for the Warriors. Anderson comes in for Heald. And that's good as he hits both shots. 1:36 left in the first quarter. Now here's Pajimski, defended by Thompson. And here's Pajimski, still without a bucket. And here's Curry for 3. Nails it from 3.
Off a pass, Steph Curry. That one is always going in, or almost always going in.
Van Vliet on the wing. He's covered by Curry. That one drops for him. Van Vliet's got 13 now.
Did not take him long to get into the flow of this game, knocking down 5 of his first 7 shots.
Curry looking it over. There's 47 seconds left in the first quarter here. That shot is off. Whitmore with it. Kuminga's on him. And Whitmore gets it to go on the assist from Van Vliet.
Athleticism showing through from Whitmore. He doesn't need much room at all to operate in close.
Van Vliet against Curry. From the high post, he drains it. Made half his shots. He's 5 for 10 now.
You know, he's got to be exasperated right now, fellas. I mean, playing excellent ball, but they're still losing.
Van Vliet against Curry. And the basket by Van Vliet. 15 points in the game.
Yeah, their defense is starting to wear down. That's 3 straight buckets at the rim.
Outside Curry. Throws it up high! And Kuminga throws it down.
I would imagine it's nearly impossible to not get fired up after that play.
Grant, check these guys out on the bench. Their reaction says it all. They are fired up.
And that's what those alley-oops will do for a team. Ignition switch ignited.
No shortage of scoring here at the end of the first quarter. The Rockets on top. They're up by 6. And we'll be back in just a minute with the start of the second quarter. And thanks again for tuning in. If you're just joining us, we played through one quarter of action so far. And taking a look at Houston's performance here, guys, what have they been doing or not doing?
Well, what I love is the tremendous belief in their bench. They were looking for points and their reserves delivered.
And you know, when the bench is playing such a big role early, that certainly allows the starters to stay fresh throughout the game.
This is how the floor looks for the Rockets starting the second. They've got Tari Eason, Fred Van Vliet out there with Amin Thompson. Then it's Steven Adams, and it's Whitmore in at the 3. All right, Grant, give it to us straight here. What's the deal with star treatment in the NBA, you think?
Star treatment? What is that, B.A.? No, I think some players have a reputation which might help them on 50-50 calls. And you could argue that some players have a reputation that hinders them on the 50-50 calls. So it really just all depends.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
And he knocks down the first one. Both free throws, good for Kuminga. Houston leading by 4. Now here's Van Vliet. Adams with a screen on Curry. Van Vliet, the pass to Adams. Stolen by Anderson. Oh, and a fast break for the Warriors. Here's Kuminga. Perfect night so far, 2 for 2. And so Thompson will bring it up for the Rockets. It's off to L.A. after this game, where they'll face the Clippers. That'll be the 3rd stop of this 4-game trip. The shot's good.
And they've really managed to dominate inside.
The play in the paint has gone almost entirely all their way.
And let's swing it over to the sideline and hear from Allie.
Well, Coach Steve Kerr said of Jonathan Kuminga, we were trying really for a long time to get him to attack, get the ball in the paint and dunk it, because he's unstoppable there. You just don't know when something's going to click, but it has clicked, and it's beautiful to see.
He has certainly found his lane, Allie. Thank you.
Yeah, still close, but with their tough play on the boards, we're certainly seeing the effort.
Eason a screen on Curry. Six to shoot. Curry against Van Vliet. And it's good with time running down on the shot clock. Now it's a six-point Rocket lead. Golden State has gone 4 of 8 from three. A nice percentage. Pass to Kuminga. Over Eason. Kuminga's shot is off.
Most nights this shot would have been his, but the defender gave him just enough trouble.
And he's headed to the line for two. He gets the whistle there.
Yeah, I like when Thompson goes in strong like this. I mean, just forcing the defense to act.
First trip to the free throw line for him in this one. Free throws good from Thompson.
And what I like about Thompson, along with the high-level athleticism, he has a high-level feel for the game.
Draymond Green, he's checked in for the Warriors. Wiggins comes in for Melton. And a change for the Rockets. Brooks is checked in. So he hits one of two from the stripe.
The athletic ability of Amen Thompson is easily seen. The way he runs, he's fluid, and how physical he can get, boy, that combination is potent.
Curry's shot is off.
And they just continue to dominate the boards.
Guys, I think they've simply been the more physical team, and that's why they're ahead.
Now here's Thompson. He has seven. Adams with the ball. Adams double team. Brooks, the pass to Thompson. And he finishes. That makes him 4 out of 5.
They're winning the battle down low by imposing their will.
Yeah, it's really been quite a contrast. I like the way they're attacking the middle on at their offensive end.
The three from Curry. Adams grabs the miss. Adams has got rebound number 8 now. Adams with a screen on Curry. And here's Van Vliet from the arc. They grab their own miss. So a moment now to see the story for Tari Eason.
And over the last 5 games, his field goal percentage has increased. And you can make a case his confidence as well because of this.
This is his first opportunity at the line this evening.
And guys, this has not been a season to remember for him at the free throw line, certainly to this point.
That free throw misses.
Boy, you got to be able to capitalize at the foul line. They're struggling with that this quarter.
Alperen Şengün's checked in for Eason. So we can't get either to fall. And you see player training methods, Grant, a lot more than just running and getting shots up.
And you know, B.A., what interests me, players not just training their bodies better than ever, but also their minds. They're working on hand-eye coordination drills and just all kinds of stuff to enhance their reflexes.
And we've got a timeout called by Ime Udoka. He's going to gather the troops and talk it over. Eason's checked in for Houston.
And some of the best high flyers in the NBA. Some of this year's contenders for the dunk contest.
And when you look at the names on that list, you just know that contest has a chance to be special.
And you look at Smith. He's a long shot at this point, but you never know.
Well, we'll just have to see. But I personally would love seeing him in the dunk contest.
And as All-Star Weekend gets closer, we'll of course update you on how things are looking. But this year already promises plenty of standout performances.
Yeah, this is going to be a dunk contest you don't want to miss.
Now here's Pajemski. Yet to see a basket. They get it again. Second chance shot. Curry, no good.
Oh, love the intensity in which they're hitting the boards.
Guys, that's been the key to their lead. I mean, simply put, the effort they've displayed on the glass has been the difference. Not much falling for him this quarter, guys, and you can sense his frustration.
He's lost his rhythm completely this quarter, but he's determined to stay after it.
Van Vliet finds Brooks. Back to Van Vliet. Brooks outside. Pass to Thompson. Here's Van Vliet. Missed inside.
This has not been his best quarter.
You know, guys, it seems to me as though he's over-anxious. He seems to be pressing, trying too hard, moving too fast. Just needs to calm himself down and wait for good shots.
Van Vliet against Curry. Here's Van Vliet. He's got 17. Three-pointer. Van Vliet missing again.
He's lost his momentum in a big hurry. Coming off an excellent quarter, now he just can't find the bucket.
Curry with it. Van Vliet covering. Curry passes to Kuminga. Wiggins looking around. Down low. Green. Oh, Green just outworking the competition.
A wrecking ball inside. Once again, Draymond imposing his will.
Outside Eason. Pass to Thompson. Brooks outside to stop the drought. Houston with another miss. Golden State has gone 1-4 from three-point land here in the second. And he lobs it up. Tipped. Oh, it's stolen by Eason. Thompson finds Brooks. Now Van Vliet. Just five on the clock. The Warriors pull it in. Curry's got four rebounds in the game. If you look at rebounding rate, Tari Eason is one of the best in the NBA, Clark.
Yeah, you think about rate, it basically looks at what percentage of rebounds do you get while you're on the floor. And Eason is prolific in terms of boards per minute. Uses his 6'8 frame well, and he's gobbling up rebounds at well under one every 3 minutes. That is, that's a lot of heavy lifting there, folks.
Yes, it's good.
The fancy dribbling from Thompson. I mean, showing he's not afraid to take some risk on offense.
Outside, Green. Pass to Wiggins. To the middle. Here's Kuminga. The kick out, Curry. Golden State needs to get off a shot. Fires for three. It's rebounded by Şengün. Houston leading by four. Thompson left side. Pass to Van Vliet. Takes one from 10 feet. Uses the glass to drop it in. Van Vliet's got 19 points.
Fred Van Vliet has his fingerprints all over this one. Just dominating the defense right now.
Back to Curry. There's a screen by Kuminga. The three ball. Easy money for Stephen Curry.
It looks easy, effortless. Curry, natural from long range.
And Ime Udoka has called timeout, and we might see some changes. Coach potentially looking to adjust.
And some changes here for the Warriors. Jackson Davis is checked in for Kuminga, and Hield is subbed in for Pajemski. And the Rockets making a change here as well. Jalen Green, he's checked in for Van Vliet. And it's Green with the ball for the Rockets. Their biggest lead of the game was 9. Eason inside, working on Green. Eason can't get it to go. Warriors trail by 3. Curry passes to Hield. Shot clock at 6. Green for 3. And the Warriors with another 3!
When you let a team knock down that many threes, you know you're likely to be on the wrong side of a run.
Houston has gone 0 for 4 from beyond the arc here in the second quarter. Şengün, the screen. Thompson with it, and it's Hield picking him up. They get it back. Thompson passes to Eason. Yes, and a nice assist from Thompson. Eason's got his first 2 points of the night. Golden State has got 7 of their 16 three-point attempts to go in. Green against Curry. Back to Wiggins. Green, a screen. Wiggins gets a step, and there's the slam dunk to finish it off.
This is the dilemma defensively. I mean, when Wiggins glides off the pick, he's hard to shadow.
Brooks outside. Outside Eason. Inside. Here's Green. Got a hand on it. Green against Eason. Oh, a clear foul there on the missed shot. So he'll get a pair at the line.
Nice work that time by Draymond to draw the foul while in the act of shooting there.
And this will be a second trip to the free throw line.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
And the free throw is good. Now leading by 1. Houston making some changes. Smith, he's checked in for Eason. And Fred VanVleet is subbed in for Thompson. Second free throw, no good. Since being selected in the 21 draft, Alperen Şengün has really improved.
Yeah, from 9 points per game as a rookie to over 20 in his third year, Şengün has averaged about 5 assists per game over a season. A huge number for a 6'11 post guy. He is so skilled.
Now here's Brooks. No points so far. Van Vliet outside. To the inside. Lets it go. And there's Şengün on the assist by Van Vliet. Van Vliet's got 5 assists in the game. Outside, Green. And there's the call on Jalen Green. That's his first foul. Green against Smith. From 13, Draymond! Oh, such a force inside!
He's been a steady presence for them. Nice to have that kind of safety net at the offensive end.
Hield against Green. Van Vliet outside. No good from outside.
He came out today planning to do as much damage from three-point range as possible. Well, it looks like it's time to change up the plan, guys.
Throw it down on the lob.
A top passer at his position. Green really takes pleasure in feeding his guys and getting them going.
Van Vliet against Curry. Pass to Şengün. Good work defensively by Jackson Davis. The Warriors lead by 3. 59 seconds left to play in the first half. And he was camped in the lane there. He gets a 3-second call. Rockets trail by 3. Van Vliet, the pass to Şengün. Now here's Green. Pass to Brooks. Now Smith. Green with the ball. Guarded by Hield. Oh, he powers right through the defender for the dunk. Draws the foul, too. And he'll go to the line. Trayce Jackson-Davis picks one up. Clark, what catches your eye about Jalen Green at a fundamental level?
Well, it starts with his pure explosiveness. That just jumps out at anybody because he's jumping over everybody, okay? The way he can get up and down the floor and hang and lift. That's what stands out, his athleticism. And he's rounding into, he's actually rounding off some of the rough edges in his game that makes him kind of scary as we go forward.
Hey, it's hard not to gush about Green. I mean, he's one of the more exciting talents to enter this league in quite some time.
Curry, no good.
The battle of the boards has been something to watch.
Yeah, tit for tat on the glass. Just one more aspect of what's been a very closely contested ball game here.
Now 5 seconds separating the shot clock and the game clock. Clock at 6. Green against Hield. And it's Green missing. Fires away from way outside. Oh, it would have counted had it fallen, but it is offline. So the clock runs out with the score tied going into the half. We'll see you after halftime for the beginning of the third quarter.
You know, for the Rockets, you know, Halloween was a long time ago, but this team is still the scariest group in the league. They're striking fear into every team that has to go against them, Shaq.
You're starting to scare me, Kenny.
Oh.
And now let's talk Golden State. They're in an even matchup through one half of play.
What a job they did from three-point land. I don't know if they can keep this up, though, Kenny.
Yeah, it's hard to hit threes at this pace for a whole game, but hey, as long as you're hot, keep taking them.
And that's it for halftime. Thank you for joining us. We send you back to Brian Anderson for the start of the third quarter.
And we're halfway through this one. Plenty of basketball left in a game that's been a fairly even one. Oh, we're seeing a tremendous game from Fred VanVleet.
Yeah, he's kind of been the floor general for them tonight. A lot of assists for him.
And, you know, that's not a job they ask him to do very often. But in the first half, I thought he was in perfect sync with his teammates.
Here's Curry. Inside, it's Green next to Jackson Davis. Curry and Heal to the sharp shooting backcourt. And it's Wiggins in at the small forward position. And that's the group for Steve Kerr as we begin the second half. Now here's Green. Van Vliet outside. Şengün, a screen on Curry. And here's Van Vliet from the arc. Drills it from deep. Van Vliet's got 22 points.
Just another day doing what he does. Van Vliet lines it up and drills it.
A moment to hear from Allie LaForce.
Hey, Brian. The Rockets showing improvement. Head coach Ime Udoka said, quote, "When you rely on your young guys, you're constantly trying to instill habits that'll carry them for the rest of their careers. It's mistakes and tendencies you have to try to break continually. Just staying positive. We see glimpses of how close we can be."
All right, Allie. Thanks for that.
Looks like we're starting to see a pattern here. Not afraid to get in the paint and get wet.
Well, I agree with you. 4 of their last 5 baskets have been exactly of that variety.
Now here's Brooks. Hasn't gotten one to fall yet. Back to Van Vliet. Pass to Brooks. Shoots over Wiggins. Warriors with the rebound. Third quarter of basketball. We're about a minute and a half in. Curry passes to Green. Wiggins with it. Jackson Davis, a screen. Heeled up top. From outside the arc. It's rebounded by Şengün. Şengün's got 7 rebounds in the game. Green against Heald. This one for 3. Rebounded by Heald. Heald's got 4 rebounds now. Pass to Curry. And here's Wiggins. And it's good. Assisting on the play was Curry. Curry's got his 4th assist with that last one. Şengün, the screen. Here's Van Vliet. The Rockets with another miss.
This isn't how they wanted to start the second half. Only 1 of 4.
Here's Heald. Wiggins outside. Pass to Jackson Davis. It counts! And the foul! It goes on Fred Van Vliet.
They're not messing around. 5 of their last 6 buckets have come from the interior.
And this is his first trip to the line tonight. Rockets trail by 5. Brooks outside to the paint. Here's Smith. Oh, the dunk by Smith.
Yeah, what an athlete Smith is. Excellent at rising up to punch it home.
Pass to Jackson Davis. Up top Curry, guarded by Van Vliet. Heald for 3. Hits a 3-pointer. Heald's got 5 points now this quarter.
And what's working here? Each guy is willing to make the next pass.
Van Vliet against Curry. With a 9-footer. And off the front iron, and in it goes. Van Vliet's got 24 points.
And when Van Vliet kicks it up a notch, get out of his way. Keep letting him do his thing.
Curry passes to Wiggins. Now Curry. Outside, Green. Pass to Heald. 4 on the clock. Off target from outside.
And he probably thought he was going to bury that one.
Brooks, the pass to Şengün. Smith outside. Now Brooks lets the 3 fly. Nails it from beyond the arc.
And when Brooks has his jumper working, the defense needs to locate him as soon as they can.
Outside Heald. Now Jackson Davis. 7 points in the game. Outside Green. Jackson Davis, a screen. Green in the post. Covered by Smith. And it's Green missing. And Van Vliet has got the ball here for the Rockets. Green, the pass to Van Vliet. Green with the ball. And no good. Had a chance to take the lead. Pass to Curry. Back to Green. Oh! Green dropping the hammer!
Green showing you some real attitude on that throwdown.
Rockets trail by 3. Van Vliet outside. Now Green for the tie. The Warriors pull it in. Jackson Davis has got 6 rebounds in the game.
He's been just a little off the mark tonight. Really the story of the game so far.
Jackson Davis, a screen. They get it back. Pass to Curry. Healed for three. Smith with the rebound. Houston has gone 2 for 5 from three since halftime. Down low. And Şengün throw it down.
Şengün finishing with authority. There you go, big fella. Make him feel you.
Outside, Green. Now here's Wiggins. 4-3, and that comes off the assist by Green. Green's got 7 assists in the game.
He's been shooting with great consistency tonight.
Timeout.
Love to see that confident play on offense.
And we've got a timeout called by Ime Udoka. He's going to talk it over with his guys.
And the Warriors making a switch here. Pajimski's checked in. And a change for the Rockets. Thompson's checked in.
Van Vliet outside. Back to Thompson. Van Vliet outside. Drives to the hoop. Yep, that one goes. Van Vliet's got 26. The Warriors have gotten 6 of their first 12 shots to drop in this third.
And you know, Clark, Fred Van Vliet gives you a number of things. Leadership might be the most important.
It is certainly one of his great attributes, B.A., when you look at Fred Van Vliet. Not very big, not super athletic, but a winner. Tough, tough-minded, and highly skilled. Doesn't make mistakes with the ball, gets other people shots, and has proven to be a clutch and consistent quarterback at a really high level.
Outside Pajimski. Shot clock at 6. Ooh, stolen by Smith.
I just don't love the passing angle there. Might have been better to reset.
Green finds Smith. Here's Van Vliet. Green covering. Pass to Thompson. And he's going for the lob! Out of bounds, it'll go to the Warriors. And a chance now to look at the schedule for the Golden State Warriors. On Friday, they'll be taking on Rudy Gobert and the Minnesota Timberwolves.
And that game against Memphis, that's going to be a nice test for them. They'll get a chance to see just how they play against a team that most feel is better than them.
And here's Pajimski. He's scoreless. Outside, Green. Up and over Smith. And it's Green missing. The Rockets trail. Thompson with it. Now Wiggins defending. Van Vliet outside. Şengün the screen. With some arc. Van Vliet misses. And they've been moving the ball really well tonight.
Good things come to those who take good shots.
Pass to Green. Jackson Davis, a screen, launches it. It's hauled in by Houston.
Going into halftime, he had two threes in his pocket, but hasn't added to that total since.
Now here's Thompson, hounded by Wiggins. Van Vliet outside. For the tie. Oh, Green with a block.
Green takes great pride in his defense now. He loves denying shots at the rim and playing bigger than his 6'8 frame would lead you to believe.
Now here's Heald. He's got 11. It's Wiggins on the wing, defended by Thompson. Here's Green. Their offense stone cold. Another miss there. Smith with it. Green picks him up. Thompson outside. Şengün, a screen on Wiggins. Right wing for the lead. And there's Şengün. That one's good. On the assist by Thompson. Şengün's got 5 points now in the quarter. And Steve Kerr calls timeout here. I think right now he must be looking at some adjustments.
Jonathan Kuminga, he's checked in for the Warriors.
All right, let's have a look at the leaderboard to see which team scored the most points off turnovers this past month. Second, the Warriors.
And lately, they've not only been forcing turnovers, but capitalizing on them on the other end, hustling hard to convert every time.
The Warriors trailing. Outside heel. Now here's Pajemski. He's guarded closely. Wiggins down low, working on Thompson, and it's going to be a three-second call.
And they've landed in the top 10 for team scoring. They're making smart decisions on that end and presenting a challenge for most defenses.
And you said they're second in the NBA in points off turnovers. That's all you need to know about this team. Not only do they cause mistakes, they capitalize on them. Anderson's checked in for the Warriors. Melton comes in for Wiggins. Adams checked in for Houston. Eason comes in for Smith. Melton against Van Vliet. Offensive rebound. Here's Green. And it's in after a nice bounce off the right iron. Green's got 11 points.
Exactly how you run the pick and roll. Green looking very comfortable and confident in these sets.
Pass to Pajemski. Looking to end the run. It's hauled in by Houston. Their biggest lead of the game was 9. Here's Green. And they recover it. Van Vliet outside. To the middle. Here's Adams. And it's slammed in by Adams.
This is how you run the screen and roll, folks. Van Vliet with the pinpoint pass to finish it off.
Warriors trail by 5. Pass to Heald. Back to Melton. Outside Pajemski. And there's the lob. Oh, it's stolen by Eason. Green with the ball. Now Pajemski defending. They grab their own miss. Tries again. And that one drops.
Green's gotten four this quarter.
You know, with his quickness, he's already good at creating separation for his shot. And we know he doesn't need much room to get his shot off either.
And Steve Kerr calls timeout here. We might see him looking to make some tweaks to the strategy here. Stephen Curry, he's checked in for Heald. Whitmore's checked in for the Rockets. All right, let's look at the last handful of seasons and the steals numbers for DeAnthony Melton.
And when you see the decline his steal totals have taken the last few years, you can see that he's not playing that type of gritty, intense D that he's used to. That's a part of his game he needs to bring back.
Pass to Kuminga to win the drought, and he'll draw the foul. He'll head to the line for two. It's going to be on Tari Eason. All right, guys, let's get your take on the scoring breakdown for the Rockets.
You know, all game long, they've imposed their will on the interior, scoring a lot of points in the painted area.
Also, lots of hustle on the offensive end, following shots and creating tons of second-chance opportunities.
First one falls. Both free throws, good for Kuminga. 1:25 left in the third. Van Vliet against Curry. Pass to Thompson. The rebound by Melton. Warriors trail by five. Anderson with it. He's picked up by Eason. Anderson can't get it to go. Houston has gone 3 of 7 from deep so far in the third quarter. To the paint. Eason, the pass to Adams. Van Vliet against Curry. Second chance effort. Oh, plenty of contact on that shot. Officials call the foul, and he'll take two free throws now.
Van Vliet, despite his size, he's not backing down from any contact. He looks to draw foul.
And this will be his third and fourth free throws of the game here.
And you know, with those numbers, he makes a defender hesitant to get too tight on him. I mean, he doesn't want to get whistled for the foul and put this guy on the line.
That free throw good from Van Vliet.
An NBA champion and all-star. Fred Van Vliet's a guy every team wants because he's fun to play with, and he plays the game the right way and with passion.
Brooks, he's checked in for the Rockets. Both free throws, good from Van Vliet.
And the big X factor Van Vliet brings to the team is leadership. He's very talented at setting a good tone out on the floor and organizing his guys.
Count it. Curry's got 16 points now.
His mid-range shot is very solid. I mean, for some reason, the defense let him have it.
VanVleet against Curry. Adams with a screen on Curry. To the inside. Now here's Adams. He's covered closely. And he lays it up and in. Give him eight.
It's obvious they've taken fewer threes here in the second half and are focused on having a more balanced offensive attack.
Curry against VanVleet. Launches a three, and Curry is good for three. Curry's got 5 points now this quarter.
You can tell his hustle inspires the entire squad. He really gets everyone so amped up.
Fred VanVleet has been on display for the Houston Rockets. And this has to be his best scoring game of the season. And he's not done yet. More NBA on 2K Sports right after this. Steve Kerr with some words for his players.
Keep everything sharp. Keep the cuts hard. Cutting through contact. Passes sharp. And the ball's going to fall for us. We can't give up the easy ones down here, right?
Now, Coach Kerr, all he's asking is that his team be more precise in their decision-making.
Yeah, absolutely. He's aware of just how special they are when they're playing smart basketball.
Three tense quarters behind us. One more to go. Thanks for being with us as we get ready for the fourth. So, on the floor for Houston, Dylan Brooks is out there with Tari Eason. Then there's Amen Thompson, then it's Shepard, and it's Şengün in at the center position. Now here's Şengün. Anderson pulls it down. Pass to Curry. Melton outside. Now Kuminga. Brooks defending. Six to shoot. Brooks against Kuminga. And the rebound goes to the Rockets. Brooks has got 4 rebounds now. Thompson. Nice D from Anderson. Warriors trail by 4. Melton outside. Pass to Curry. The 3. It's good. Curry with a long range bomb.
This is exactly the kind of unique range that Curry has. I mean, as soon as he crosses half court, you got to get up on him.
Şengün, a screen on Curry. Here's Shepard. The Warriors pull it in. Melton outside. And that's out of bounds. It was last touched by Kuminga.
And this is the absolute wrong time to stop communicating. They have to get in sync.
All right, the Rockets making a switch here. Holiday has checked in. We're just over a minute and a half now into the fourth. It's Thompson, high post, all alone, and it goes straight through with a swish. And the Rockets lead by 3.
A confident shot from Amen. I mean, when he trusts his J, Thompson is that much more difficult to check.
Now here's Curry. Outside Pajemski. 6 on the shot clock. Over Brooks. Pass to Kuminga. It's deflected. Brooks outside. And here's Holiday. He's covered by Curry. We're in the fourth quarter here. Just under 2.5 minutes gone by.
Huge night for Curry and a great rhythm thus far. That's always bad news for the team he's facing.
Thompson scanning the floor. There's the drive. Got it.
And, you know, coaches will take possessions like that all day long. Phenomenal use of the screen there.
Warriors trail by 3. Outside Pajemski. Pass to Curry. Melton outside. Now Pajemski. Outside Curry. Now here's Anderson. Defended by Şengün.
Savvy play that time by Anderson. Staying in his shot and able to draw the foul.
First free throw is good.
You know, one of the things about Kyle Anderson that's so valuable is his versatility. I mean, he's somebody this team can rely on to chip in and make a difference out there in a lot of different categories.
Jackson Davis has checked in for the Warriors. Smith, he's checked in for the Rockets. And he makes both free throws. The Rockets have gone 2 of 5 from the field in this final quarter. Thompson passes to Eason. Thompson with it. It's Eason with the jam.
A great read between those two guys. The defense didn't stand a chance, B.A.
These two teammates right here, Grant, they are connected.
And I tell you what, guys, that's a big play to make in a close game. Potential momentum builder there.
Here's Curry after the basket by Houston. Pass to Jackson Davis. That misses. Had a chance to tie it. Houston leading by 3. Brooks finds Thompson. Smith with it. Anderson covers. Parked it down low that time. Got hit with the 3-second call.
Tough one. In a game where every possession is valuable, turnovers can make the difference.
Golden State has gone 1 of 2 from deep in this quarter. Curry against Thompson. Curry drives. Yep, that one's good. Curry's got 12 points here in the second half.
Curry does not just hurt you from deep. He is a clever finisher on the drive. Lethal at penetrating and finishing.
Here's Thompson. He got a piece of it. Thompson against Kuminga. Pass to Curry. To take the lead. Shoots over Eason. Curry's shot is off. The Rockets have gotten 3 of 8 shot attempts to find the net here in the fourth quarter. And the slam dunk by Thompson.
That is Thompson's game, rocking the rim and giving his team some energy.
Curry against Thompson. And here's Jackson Davis. Back to Curry. Pass to Kuminga. Outside Curry to tie it up. It's rebounded by Şengün. Şengün's got double-digit rebounds now in the game. Shot from 12. Hauled in by Curry. Curry's got 5 rebounds tonight. Inside. Anderson passes to Curry. Outside, Anderson. And he lobs it up to the rim. Oh, Kuminga! Top for days.
Oh, what a perfect pass to set that up.
Hey, the feed might have been pretty, but the finish, that was angry.
Well, you need both to make it special. And they pulled it off just right.
Smith passes to Eason. Back to Smith. Brooks with it. Smith outside. Pass to Eason. Shoots over Kuminga. Kept alive.
Hey, he's one of the best on the offensive glass, so you got to get a body on Şengün.
And so it's Curry with it. He brings it up for Golden State. Now Jackson Davis. To the inside. Here's Kuminga. And he's going to the line for 2. The official saw contact while he was going up.
The officials were right on top of that one.
Clearly a foul. I mean, didn't give him any choice but to blow the whistle. I mean, you got to play without fouling.
That free throw, no good. And some changes here for the Warriors. Green's checked in for Jackson Davis. Andrew Wiggins comes in for Anderson. And it's Buddy Hield in for Pajemski. Green's checked in for the Rockets. Van Vliet comes in for Thompson. That's off as well, so he misses both.
The NBA becoming more and more global, Clark. Şengün, a perfect example of that.
Yeah, Alperen Şengün out of Turkey. Right now on the fast track to being the best player to ever come out of his homeland. So still very young, but boy, his future is quite bright.
And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Jonathan Kuminga. That's foul number two for him. And the Warriors making a switch here. Jackson Davis has checked in. And a change for the Rockets. Dylan Brooks checked in for Eason. Houston leading by three. Now here's Van Vliet. Pass to Brooks. For three. Good. And Van Vliet gets the assist. Van Vliet's got assist number seven tonight.
A guy who shoots freely at the perimeter, Brooks, can do real damage from out there.
Now here's Wiggins. Curry with it. Down low. Here's Jackson Davis. And he makes it on the layup.
Curry's got such a great feel and understanding of the game. I mean, he can make a lot happen in the pick and roll.
Van Vliet against Curry. Smith with a screen on Curry. Van Vliet on the wing. And there's a 3-second violation. Warriors trail by four. Outside heel. Back to Curry. Pass to Wiggins. Heel to the ball. Back to Wiggins. Shot clock at six. To the paint. Here's Green. And it's hammered home by Green.
Defense gearing up to stop Wiggins' shot that time. He feels it. Hits the roller in stride. Nicely done. Good adjustment.
Van Vliet, the pass to Brooks. Back to Van Vliet. Perfect pass to set up the lay-in. Van Vliet's got 30 points.
Clutch buckets. He's paving the way as they hit the home stretch.
Pass to Jackson Davis. Back to Curry. Green against Smith. And it's Green missing. Houston leading by four. Van Vliet outside. Here's Green. Şengün, the screen. Outside, Green. Shot on the wing. And he nails that one right through the heart. And the Rockets lead by six.
Jalen Green, a really offensive-minded player. Doesn't care where he finds his shot. He's letting it fly.
Ooh, stolen by Smith. Curry against Van Vliet. Brooks outside. Outside, Green. Clock at six. Şengün, the screen. Pulls it in from the elbow. It's rebounded by Golden State. Jackson Davis has got eight rebounds in the game. Green, the pass to Curry. Takes it inside. So it'll be two free throws. He was fouled in the act of shooting. That one on Şengün.
And the quickness and change of pace of Curry makes him tough to stop.
And he makes a first.
When you talk about shot mechanics, Curry is as close as you can get to perfect. I mean, you can tell he puts a lot of work into that part of his game, and it pays off.
Oh,
That's also good, so he hits both free throws.
And he doesn't let the pressure get to him, cool and confident from the line.
Smith outside. Brooks outside. To the middle. Here's Van Vliet. And the layup is good. Van Vliet's got 13 points here in the second half alone.
Great work by Van Vliet. So good at carving out space on the interior.
Curry against Van Vliet. Shot is up. And it's good. Off the back of the rim and in. Curry's got 11 here in the quarter alone. Heald against Green. In close. Green puts it in.
Green finds ways to get it done inside. Really intelligent as a scorer.
Curry against Van Vliet. Smith with the rebound. Smith's got 5 rebounds in the game. Pass to Green. The rebound by Wiggins. Warriors trail by 6.
Things aren't looking good here. I mean, they need points and they need them now.
It doesn't look good, even with a quick bucket here.
Here's Curry. And he sinks it. They trail by just 4.
Curry is a guy you can trust to get it done when it needs to be done.
And an intentional foul right there. ...44 seconds left in the final quarter. And that's an intentional foul. So the first one drops, and that puts him up 5. So he gets them both, and it's a 6-point ball game.
Every free throw is crucial in a close game. Nice work at the line.
And Steve Kerr calls timeout. He wants to make sure they're purposeful with the game plan. Given the situation here, what sort of strategy needs to be top of mind?
No doubt. They've got to get a quick bucket here.
Yeah, and they need it hiccup fast. I mean, they'll be drawing up a quick hitter in the huddle here, no doubt.
Now here's Curry. And we've got 28 seconds left in the game. Money! And now they trail by just 4.
You see why they trust Curry. I mean, give him the rock and let him make a play.
And now we've got an intentional foul. He hits the first one, and that puts him up 5. And so he drops them both, and it's a 6-point ball game. And Steve Kerr calls timeout, rallying his guys to make sure they all know the plan. ...24 seconds left in the fourth quarter here. Here's Curry. Outside for Green. Curry, he's open. Cash! And now they trail by just 4!
And you know, for a big man, I think Green is one of the better dime droppers in the league. I mean, he's a true point forward who has excellent vision and sees the floor well.
Shooting two.
First free throw is good, and that puts him up five. And he's unable to get the second one. Hield against Van Vliet. Wiggins for three. Oh, he drained it from downtown. And we've got a timeout called by Ime Udoka. The pressure is on, and he's got a plan to share with his guys. Prolong the game with an intentional foul.
And a smart choice right there. I mean, you can't allow them to just drain the clock.
No, you got a foul. I mean, it's going to come down to free throws here. Foul right away.
Shoot two.
Good on the first. And that makes it a three-point lead. And he hits both free throws here. And it's a four-point ball game.
I think it's a wrap. When the game's on the line, he knows how to deliver the crushing blow.
And so it's the Rockets who come out on top here. This was a hard-fought, well-earned victory for them. They had to...